Hello everyone, my name is Sameer Tendulkar and today I'm going to show you how to make the rasagulla. The rasagulla is a very famous Indian dessert. It is a favorite dessert of a lot of people including me. I love the rasagulla and today I'm going to show you how to make the rasagulla. But before I show you how to make the rasagulla, let me tell you a little bit about this dessert. Now this dessert is actually made in the eastern side of India called Bengal. And Bengal is famous for two things. One, it's beautiful women, and second, the rasagulla. Now all the beautiful women, my father loves all the women from Bengal. A lot of Miss Universes have come from Bengal, and almost half of all the women in Bollywood come from Bengal. So it's famous for two things, beautiful women and the rasagulla. Now it's said that the language Bengali, which is spoken over there, is spoken with the rasagulla in the mouth. Now that has two meanings. One, if the language is really sweet, and second, everything in the language has an O in it. Rasagulla, Bengal. The capital of their state, Bengal, is Kolkata. So if you see two Indian looking people talking, and you hear too many O's, O's, O's in there, they're probably talking in Bengal. Also, when I was in India, and I used to travel to Kolkata a lot on business. So there was this one friend of mine, Gypsum Verghese, used to always fly with me to Kolkata just to taste the rasagulla. It is so famous, people love it so much. So let me show you how to make this recipe. In order to make the rasagulla, you need 10,000 different things.
Nah, I'm just playing with you.
So in order to make the rasagulla, you just need three ingredients. Sugar, milk and lime. The milk, this is half a gallon of milk. This will make approximately 20 rasagullas. You can use quarter gallon and that will give you 10 rasagullas. Quarter gallon is approximately 1 liter, so you can choose how many ever you want. The lime and the sugar approximately remain the same, so, and these are super light, so they go fast, so you can choose however you want. I'm using half a gallon, you can choose how many ever you want.
So in order to make the rasagulla, you need to boil the milk. So in order to boil the milk, make sure you add the milk to a cold container and then turn the heat on. Don't try to put it in a hot container, it might not turn out as good. So you have the container, the heat is off at the moment, and I'm adding the milk to the container. This is half a gallon. So there we go. I added half a gallon of milk to the container and now I'm turning the heat on. And the heat is at medium at the moment. And you need to keep stirring it. After 30 seconds, add the lime and water mixture. I've added 2 limes to about a cup of water. So, now as you can see, the milk has separated. Now what we're going to do is we're going to drain the water and just keep this over here. So we'll show you that in 2 minutes. Now in a glass bowl, add a colander, try and add a cloth and try to drain out the water from the mixture. So here you have it. Now we have to squeeze the water. Make sure you're careful because this is hot. Remember not to squeeze it too much because that will make it dry and then it won't be so good. And now we hang this either over the bathroom tap or someplace for half an hour and let it stand as is for half an hour. Now that our separated milk has been hanging for close to half an hour. Now we open this and here we have it. It's like a ball and then we knead it like dough. Also make sure that you don't knead it too much because that could make it hard. So once you finish kneading it, just make them into small balls, and it's okay if it has a few cracks in it, so that will help the sugar water go inside and make it into a sweet puffy ball. Now remember something about these. Now the thing with rasgullas is you have to eat it whole in one shot. So just make them into, make sure that the balls are small, because they puff up to almost twice the size. So if you make them big, they'll become really big. So the balls have to be small. So try to make them small so that, you know, such that if it becomes twice the size, it's still a bite size. Because they have to go, you have to eat them one, and it has to be a little struggle eating it. You have to open your mouth wide to eat them. If it's small, like mini rasgullas, it's not so much fun. So now, in a pot, take 10 cups of water and add 2 cups of sugar. This is 1 cup. This is the second cup. If you want, you can close the lid. Now, as you can see, our sugar water mixture has started to boil, and to this we add our rasgullas. And we're going to boil this for 15 minutes, stirring every 5 minutes. So make sure your heat is at medium. So now 15 minutes are up. We turn the heat off, and our rasgullas have been boiling for 15 minutes. We just very light-handedly stir them. If you're rough with them, there's a good chance that they could crack, they could break. So make sure you're doing it, you stir them very gently. So this is done. We let it cool for 7 hours or overnight, whichever. And we'll see how it is, how it turns out. So see you guys in 7 hours. As you can see, the rasgulla has come out really soft. You see? So this is what you're looking for.
And here we have it, our final product, the rasgulla. It's come out really good. It's already rested for 7 hours, actually overnight. I kept it overnight and it's ready. So let's see how it's come out. Also, when you're when you're making the rasgulla, you should have the whole thing and not break them in the water. So, it's amazing. So go ahead, try this at home and let me know how it comes out. If you like this recipe, click on the like button. If you made this recipe, click on the I made it button and add photos of your rasgullas. I would love to see how they came out. If you have other recipes that you've made, add videos of you making the recipe, or even pictures of you making the recipe. I would love to see the pictures and the videos that you add. If you like me and the videos that I put, or the recipe that I put, then follow me on kaan.com and you'll be able to see all the other recipes that I make. Thank you so much. Have a great day.